it's obviously from fees and business. So, okay, the main idea is that while we have an amount of data regarding a lot of attributes of fees, we have little genetics data that we can correlate with that. While that correlation probably going to be to have really interesting results. So, for the specific idea, the major idea is to try from data that are provided to us or this kind of data to identify high bacteria in aquaculture, and with that knowledge to try to do genetic monitoring and consulting to the fisheries. So, we find data about bacterial infection and the percentage of lethal of mortality, and we see that more than one bacteria species infect fish, and we measured the percentage of their lethality. Okay, so we have a simultaneous infection that they're affecting the population of the livestock with, in some cases, huge losses. And except from that, some individuals we see that they're resistant to those infections. So, what we're trying to do is from identifying those individuals that are resistant to find genetic markers that then we can try to find which individual fish has those markers, so to have to make lineages while breeding those fish that are going to be resistant to those bacteria. Okay. Okay. So the genetic part of the project is we propose two methods that they're going to give us two different kinds of results. The one is to have genetic markers. First of all, we try to find the species, that are resistant. We're then going to genotype those fish to try to identify the molecular background that why those particular fish is resistant to the specific bacteria. And the second, so that is going to pinpoint in the molecular background of the resistance and probably pinpoint us to specific genes or polymorphs of the genes. And the second analysis is going to be again genetic markers, and this specific for this specific task is going to be microsatellites. So we're going to make this analysis to the broodstock. So when we find an offspring that it's going to be that it seems to be resistant, we can trace back its parent and keep those fish. Okay. And finally, we try to do a cost assessment regarding the cost of to do those techniques and the potential cost of the loss after the infection.
Okay.
So, we try to the data we used was some of the data sets that provided from Blue Ridge. It was actually the Aqua Alert. As species of interest, seabream, but we can apply the same thing to any desired species. And we did the two analyses that I explained before. So, what we found? We found almost 800 incidents regarding the seabream, in which we identified almost 50 unique combination of bacteria in those cases. When we did that, we tried to find, we checked the mortality of the samples, and we find that a mean value of almost 50% with some higher values to 66%. For that we have identified the bacteria species combination with the most high lethalities. Okay, at this point we try to make a cost assessment, but unfortunately we try to take data from FAO, the server probably crashed, so we have to improvise and use the critical data. So, So we said we estimated that in a cage there are going to be 60,000 fish, and the price is going to be 4 euros per kilo. The fishery probably is going to, the profit of the fishery could be 20% of that, and that the Fisac are going to sell at 350 grams. So we find, as I said before, the mortality, and with those numbers, we try to see how many individuals in this situation are going to die. So we see a medium of almost 30,000 fish per cage, with higher level, higher values to be to almost 40,000. So, the economic impact of those infections, we see that many losses, okay, if those fish we survive and you are going to sell it, okay, if you lose those species, the mean losses was approximately 8,000. The cost for the analysis that we propose is actually 10,000 for 1,000 individuals for the broodstock. So we believe it's a cost-effective technique regarding the potential losses, and we're going to use that technique only once in the lifetime of the fish. And one other thing is that if you have that data, you can associate it with a lot of other characteristics that you can find regarding your fish. The fish in the fishery. So that was, thank you for your attention.